गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, सोशल साइंस सेवेंथ क्लास. इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट जियोग्राफी चैप्टर 12 नॉर्थ अमेरिका एंड वी आल्सो डिस्कस्ड अबाउट एक्सटेंट लोकेशन एंड फिजिकल फीचर्स एंड क्लाइमेट ऑफ नॉर्थ अमेरिका. बट टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट नेचुरल वेजिटेशन. ऑल ऑफ यू लुक एट द picture here. They have given the natural vegetation and animal, I mean natural vegetation which spread over the entire continent. Okay, so it has different relief features and climate we can see. At the same time, variety of vegetation also found in this continent, in different parts of the continent. So of course they based on the climatic conditions, okay, and soil and relief features. So this is how the vegetation has been spread. And you look at the picture where we could see this white color, which Greenland, Denmark, and we can see this near Alaska. These places are called tundra vegetation. So the entire vegetation broadly divided into 7. Okay, so this color which we see on the map, okay, this is this color which represents tundra vegetation. And next coniferous forest. So that below that we can see this green color. Okay, so that is coniferous forest. Okay, and we can also see next color is temperate mixed forest. Okay, light green, which you see this part, this is temperate mixed forest. And next below that we can see yellow, that is yellow color temperate grassland. This is temperate grassland where prairies will be found. Okay, so that is between Rockies, that is in USA. Okay, it is found between Rockies and Mississippi River. Okay, so that is called prairies, that is temperate grassland. And Mediterranean forest. So Mediterranean forest, look at this pink color. So this is called Mediterranean forest. Okay, sorry, not this color, this is Mediterranean forest. Okay, look at the blue color, that is the Mediterranean forest. And pink color is hot and semi-desert. This is hot and semi-desert. And last one, dark green, which we see, that is tropical rainforest. Okay, so where heavy rain occurs, that is tropical rainforest. So this is how the natural vegetation and natural vegetation has been now divided into 7 parts. Okay, and varieties of vegetation found in the entire continent. Okay, so in this, if you take it especially the tundra type of climate, first let us discuss about tundra type of climate. So here most of them are coniferous forest, and at the same time you can understand, so here it is covered by snow, it is frozen. Since it is frozen, so the much vegetation is not found here. Only like this tundra, especially near the Arctic Circle, this kind of forest has been found. Okay, so that is, we can say that Canada, Alaska and Greenland. Okay, so this is Greenland, Canada, Alaska, okay, near Alaska and Greenland. So that type of tundra type of vegetation will be found. In this region, winters are long because of freezing, and at the same time, summers are short. The vegetation found here, actually only few plants grows there. They are very short, and at the same, they are called mosses and lichens. Some stunted flowering plants are also grown here in summer season. The animals which are found here in this, especially reindeer and a caribou, they are actually important animals which are found in the tundra region. At the same time, you can see carnivores like polar bears and Arctic foxes are important animals in this region. At the same time, you can also understand about some of the, this is below that we can see temperate climate region. Okay, just below that, this is actually belt coniferous forest called taiga.
Just below the tundra region, we can see that coniferous forest. That is called taiga. The coniferous forests are evergreen, and spices like pine, fir, spruce, birch, so etc. I mean, these kind of trees are found there. Okay, the fur-bearing animals are also found here, especially lynx and sable, silver fox, or etc. So that will be which you can see. So these are actually fur-bearing animals. It means fur-bearing animals means they have thick fur in order to protect from the cold, especially in the region of Alaska and in the Greenland. Okay, these kind of animal live there. So because since it is frozen, so they wanted to protect their body. So that's why they have thick bear in their body. Okay, sorry, thick fur in their body in order to have protection from the cold. And next one, we can see the next forest is deciduous forest. Deciduous type of found in the east and southeast of the St. Lawrence River. Great Lakes, northern part is cold and southern part is remains warm. Okay, winters are cold but summers are warm, and rainfall occurs usually in summer. So the trees which are found here, they shed their leaves in the autumn. And example, cypress, oak, ash and chestnut are the important trees grow there. And the wild animals found here include, that is beaver, black bear, muskrat and a porcupine. And come to the cool temperate climate. Okay, so they are found is a part of USA, especially there where, especially already I told you, the grassland which is found between Rockies and Great River Mississippi basin, which is also known as the prairies. Prairies is a temperate grassland. This actually, of course, since grass grow there, it is a treeless plain, okay, where much trees are not found. This plain is suitable for the growth of wheat. That's why they grow enormous wheat there. That's why it is known as the wheat bowl. It is called wheat bowl or bread basket of the world. Okay, prairie grassland. So this is the picture of the prairie grassland and this cypress and chestnut trees. And next page number 128, we can see the coniferous and deciduous trees are found in the temperate mixed forest. Here, Canada and North California have such forests. The important trees found in this region are beech, maple oak trees. Mahogany and ebony also grow there. Okay, mahogany tree. This is mahogany tree, maple tree. Okay, so Canada is a country of lakes and it is formed by abundant population. Taiga type of forest, largest exporter of wood in the world. The southern part, if you take Mexico and West Indies, so which have group of islands, there you can see they have the tropical forest and mixed forest found here with hardwood and longwood. The western coast, especially where the rainfall is very less and where the population is less, the western coast, especially California, experience the Mediterranean type of climate. The vegetation is typically adjusted with the long summer drought. So here some of the trees grow, especially you know that Mediterranean Sea is the king of fruit, where most of the fruits are exported to other countries. So here some of the citrus fruits will be grown, olives, oak, cork. Okay, and it is also especially orange. The desert condition is found in the western part of the continent, already I told you, since the rainfall is less there, especially in South California, Mexico and Arizona here. So the typical example of cactus is the Joshua. One of the typical cactus name called Joshua. Okay, in the desert. The desert nights are called winters of desert. Desert nights are called here winters of deserts. Okay, and agriculture. Now let us discuss about the agriculture. So this is the different climatical conditions, at the same time different vegetations which are found in the continent. And if we discuss about agriculture is important occupation of North America, especially this is found in the central lowlands, especially Canada and USA. They are the high productive agricultural countries, only 10% of the total area in North America is suitable for agriculture. But the production from their farms is very high. Here the important crops are grown here. So that is especially, they have different belt. So they have different crop belt. So regions specialized in the production of specific crops are known as crop belt. Very important to remember. Regions specialized in the production of specific crops are known as crop belt. So in the actually they have divided into different belt based on the growth of the crop. Okay, that is corn belt, wheat belt, cotton belt, tobacco belt, like that. So different regions, they have kept the name crop belts. And wheat is one of the popular cereals grown here in North America and especially Canada and USA. The prairie region provides the best soil for wheat cultivation. And one more is important crop is here, maize. Maize is popularly known as corn. It is also grown extensively in the United States and Mexico. Most of the maize is used for feed crop, feeding cattle and pigs. Okay, so maize, actually in the beginning it was a staple food grain, but later on it was converted into as a check crop. Okay, and next wheat. Wheat, the other popular crops apart from wheat, barley and oat, potato also grown. And oats is used for feeding crop for the animals. Potato is also grown in the continent which serves as a food crop. Okay, so here they have divided the food crops as well as the economical crops, or what we say that which provides more money crops. So they are especially cotton and tobacco are grown in cash crops. Okay, cash crops, they are called cash crops. Okay, so the cotton belt along the Mississippi Valley, USA and Mexico are important producers of long staple cotton. So there are two types of cotton. One is long staple and short staple cotton. Okay, where they provide a long thread. Okay, where they have a lot of demand in the world. And tobacco grown in the South USA, Cuba, Jamaica and Mexico. The US ranks second after China among major tobacco growing countries of the world. It means it gets second rank to grow tobacco. Okay, USA ranks second after China. Okay, China is first rank and USA second rank in growing tobacco. And sugarcane is another important crop grown here. Cuba is the third largest producer of sugar in the world. So popularly, that's why it is called sugar bowl. Okay, so where the wheat is grown more, that place is called wheat bowl of the world, and Cuba is called the sugar bowl of the world. Sugar beet is also grown here, the USA. It is a major source of making sugar after sugarcane. Next, let us move on to another important two crops are coffee and cocoa. Okay, so here coffee and cocoa are the tropical plantation crops grown here, especially in the Central America and West Indies. Fruits like grapes, oranges, lime, apple. Okay, so these will be grown here. Especially California produces 90% of the wine by using grapes in North America. Therefore, California is called the wine country. Okay, it is the largest producer of wine, where most of the oranges, lime, apples will be grown in that particular country. Okay, so and also shallow continental shelves such as Grand Banks, okay, and George's Banks of New England. So these are famous for the fishing grounds. And next, let us discuss about important minerals and industries. Okay, so North America, yes, of course, it is blessed with abundant resources, such as many minerals are available here. Gold, copper, silver, iron, coal, petroleum, okay, and many other minerals are available, zinc including. And it is, of course, it's one of the largest producer of gold, which is famous for the gold mine. Okay, so gold is the first mineral mined in North America. So that is mined especially in Yukon Valley and California. And we can also understand Lake Superior and its surrounding is famous for the iron ore. And the high grade iron is found in the around Canadian Shield. And Mexico is the world major producer of silver. USA is the leading producer of copper in the world. It is also mined in Canada. Fossil fuels are exploited in a considerable quantities throughout the continent. Okay, and Pennsylvania alone produces 20% of the world's total coal. Okay, and USA is the largest coal exporter. Oil and natural gas are found in Alaska, Texas, Louisiana, Kansas, in the western Canada and parts of Mexico. Okay, offshore of the region, ocean has good deposits of natural gas. USA is the major producer of petroleum. USA also leading production of nuclear power in the world. And we can see in the picture, gold, iron, iron ore, gold, steel, coal, copper, nickel. So these are the important mineral resources which are available in North American continent. And of course, it is blessed with many natural resources, especially we can also see silver and zinc also. Okay, and next one, we can also understand about the, already I told you in the last class, transport and industry has made the country very rich. And especially we can see many countries, most of the industries have been located because technology is has been helped the industrialization to great extent. And industries are built, okay, because of the most of the availability of raw material like iron ore, coal, copper, bauxite helps heavy industries. Okay, so especially in these countries are North America, USA and Canada are highly industrialized. The lakes region, when you take it, Lake Superior and Michigan have seen a lot of development in iron and steel industries are located there. And Pittsburgh is called the steel city due to rich coal deposits found in the Appalachian region. Hydroelectric power is easy transport facility for bulky materials. Iron and steel is the basic industry in North America. And of course, we can see automobile, shipbuilding, locomotives, heavy engineering, aircraft, etc. Wood pulp, paper, newsprint also is major industries which found in USA as well as Canada. And lumbering also found in Canada. So the people, those who do the lumbering, are engaged in lumbering, they are called the lumberjacks. Okay, lumberjacks, where pulps are cut and brought. So they are called lumberjacks. So their main occupation is lumbering in Canada. And chemical industries also famous here, especially synthetic rubber, plastic, fertilizers or medicines are produced. At the same time, you can see Chicago is famous for the plastic industry. Chicago. And meat packing is important industry here, especially this is found in Chicago and Kansas. Meat packing. Okay, electrical and electronic goods are also produced in large scale. And when you come to Central America lagging behind industry because most of the countries are small. At the same time, they have the adequate power resources, raw materials which are not available there. So that's why industrial development is not possible in the Central America. So apart from that, we can see the most part of North America has industrialized. And now let us discuss about population. When we talk about the population of America, North America, so most of them are descendants from Europeans. We can see here, most of the people speak Spanish, English, French, or American Indian languages. Okay, so they are called, some of them are called indigenous people. Okay, so indigenous people means they are migrated. Some of them are migrated from other country. Now, and also we can see population density is highest in the highlands of Mexico and Central America, but much of the northern part of the continent almost empty. Why northern part of the continent is almost empty? Because it is frozen, and at the same time we can see the Greenland and Alaska region, which is not suitable for the for living, at the same time not suitable for the agriculture and not suitable for living. So that is the main reason why the most of the North America, especially North American northern part, is always empty. I mean, population is zero, we can say that. Okay, or some percent we can say. So the density populated parts, especially USA, are urban centers and industrial regions. Nearly 98% of the population found in North America, that is in USA urban, USA, United States of America. And the population of the Caribbean island is less. Okay, that is found in the southeastern part of the North America, where the settlement, tribal settlement, or settlement is dense due to the limited availability of land. Okay, settlement is less there. Okay, what is the reason? Because limited availability of land. Okay, land is less, so that's why the population also less there. Okay, so that is about North America vegetation, industries, minerals, as well as population. Okay, so if you have any doubt, you can clarify in the next class. Thank you.